Driverless cars are no longer just the stuff of science fiction.
Where am I?
You're in a Johnny cab.
Autonomous vehicles are on their way. And while they could improve safety on our roads, reduce emissions and get us from A to B quicker, they also pose a tricky question. How should they be programmed to make life and death decisions when a crash is unavoidable? The Germans have got a booming car industry, which is investing heavily in driverless technology and machine learning. They've developed some rules to give manufacturers an idea of what they need to do before they sell these cars. The basic premise is simple. If a crash is unavoidable, harm the fewest possible people and treat all life equally. If this technology is programmed to treat all life as equal, then how does it decide who survives when it's one or the other? It wouldn't consider age, gender, profession, background, family ties, criminal convictions, or any other factor. If it was following these rules, a child could die to save several others. These simplified rules mean that even if three pedestrians jaywalked in front of you, a driverless car would swerve onto the footpath, injuring a bystander and you, in order to save three rule-breaking lives. Human error is reported to be the cause of 90% of crashes, so these cars will make our roads safer by reducing those. But regulators believe it's impossible to prevent all accidents. It's an uncomfortable reality, but one implication of these rules is that manufacturers may, in some circumstances, sacrifice passengers to save others. The German rules change our understanding of who's responsible for deaths, damages, and injuries. When we're behind the wheel of a car, we make split-second decisions, and they have consequences. If we're negligent, we could be liable or even face criminal charges. But if it's a machine that's responsible, then does the liability change? The Germans say manufacturers should be responsible, not the car's passengers. And it looks like Australian politicians are headed in the same direction. Ethically speaking, it's tricky to say the least. This is how our chief scientist puts it.
I don't know what the right rules are, but the debate is an important one to have. It can't be done overnight, so it should start now or very soon.
And this presents a challenge for companies trying to sell these cars. MIT research shows that while people support the idea of a car hurting the fewest possible people, they don't want to be in them. What about you?